episode 3141, Once in a Blue Moon.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. I hope you're having a fabulous fry. Yay! Oh, yes, it's my favorite day of the week. Actually, it's not. I think every day is my favorite day of the week. I just, you know, I look at things so differently. But today, it's Confessions of an Upset Mama. And are you ready to get a little bit feisty? Oh, come on. We're going to do it once in a blue moon. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by AIM, inspiring connection and community. Did you notice? I mean, come on. You had to have noticed the beautiful moon. Yes, it was a super blue moon. And it's one of those things where it doesn't happen very often. Hence, once in a blue moon. And that leads me to this, because once in a blue moon, we as parents, right, you get the opportunity to add some of your own brilliance to your child's thoughts. What will you gift their mind today? And that's really what I want you to think about, because I know we've got responsibility and our responsibilities go way beyond caretaking, right? It's not just about a roof over the head, food in their tummies, and clothing and a good education. There's so much more to life than that. We want to raise up kids. Well, I'm assuming you do. I think you do if you're still listening to me. You want to raise up kids that can go out and impact the world that they touch. You don't want them to be a slum lord, so to speak, right? You don't want them to be a bump on a log. You want them to impact the world that they touch. You want them to live out their best lives, their dreams, whatever that is, whoever God is creating them to be. And as parents, it's our responsibility and truly, honestly, a privilege and an honor to be able to raise them up so they can go and impact the world and live out their dreams the way God wants them to, right? How they're creating them to become. And it's hard because we don't have all the answers, right? I mean, if we did, shoot, it'd be so nice. I mean, come on, I would be a trigillionaire. That's not even a word, but I just made it up. It sounds great because I would have all the answers, but we don't have all the answers because each of us are unique, right? You grew up and you gave your mama and dada a hard time. And, you know I gave my mom, no, I was a perfect child. Not really. I was not the perfect child, even though I pretend I'm the perfect child. No, I was not. In fact, that was one of the things I wouldn't say I suffered from, but my father expected excellence. And excellence meant perfection. And so it's hard for us as parents, right, to find the balance. I don't like that word, but I want you to think of it as harmony. What is it for your child? Because our kiddos today, they are bombarded with so much. And with all of my kiddos now in school, they're facing the challenge of expressing themselves. And let me tell you, if we don't help our children with communication, we are going to have a generational gap that is going to tear each other up. And you're already seeing signs of that right now, right? You are. I mean, just look out there, what's going on. Watch your local news if you haven't, okay? Because it is crazy out there. And we, as parents, are the greatest influencers over our children. I don't care how great technology is. I don't care who they meet online when they're gaming. I don't care if they've got a part-time job, you know, in town and they've got all these people around them. What matters is your influence on them. And so building those minds that learn what matters in life is so important. I mean, it's like the exclamation point on your responsibility. And then when you do that, you help them express themselves with respect for others, which makes for a dynamite child. And who doesn't want a dynamite child, right? It's like, sign me up. So if you're ready to take advantage of those once in a blue moon moments, raise your children higher. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Raise your children higher. You just cannot let them just be. Oh, they'll get it. They'll catch on. No, Mom, Dad, you have got to be involved in their lives. You've got to know what's going on. And I think most of us do, but it's interesting. As a homeschool mom and a traditional school mom and a private school mom and now a college mom and a grandma on top of that. Yeah, I have a lot of titles here. Not really. They mean nothing except for when I hear the word mom anywhere, it's like, who am I with that needs me? Oh, wait, I'm by myself. So it's not my child. Have you ever done that? Okay, that's for another episode. But seriously, right? We have responsibilities. And as easy as we would like our children just to kind of like grow up and do what they think they need to do, we have to be there to show them the way. And I believe just how God shows us, and then we can pass it on to our children and they learn what that means and they develop a relationship with Jesus Christ. And so it goes much further than that, right? Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Don't you want your child to live out their dreams? I know you're yelling at me saying, yes, of course we want that. Who doesn't want that? I mean, they don't even have to be our own child. And we want them to live out their dreams. I'm watching the U.S. Open. Oh, and college football is on. Yes, I watched my first couple of games. It's exciting. Actually, it was kind of a boring game. Yeah, Nebraska and Minnesota. But we'll leave that for another episode, too. But anyway, maybe you're cheering for your favorite team. And maybe you don't even follow football. That's all right. Just still stick with me because there's lots to have fun with here. It's confession day, so we're going to let it all hang out. But what was I talking about? Okay, you see how I just kind of digress into another conversation? But when we look at what we're doing, right, and how we're leading, U.S. Open, I'm coming back to it, I promise. We've got to really instill in our kids that they can do what they set their minds to. Notice what they set their minds to. Now, I've got a lot of big dreams. I was watching the U.S. Open, which I mentioned a few sentences back. Yeah, just, you know, on the spur of the moment. And this incredible United States tennis player, John Isner, has now retired. And he retired after he lost his match in round two of the U.S. Open. And I watched him play another U.S. guy. His name is Mo. It was an incredible, incredible match. Five sets to end it in a tie break that you had to get to 10 or win by two. So it was at least 10 and then you had to win by two. All right, now that's a short story of the tennis part of it. But in all of it, he's retiring. He's played 17 years. That's crazy. I think it was like 16 consecutive times at the U.S. Open. I believe that's the stat. And he played 4 years in college. NCAA champion. I mean, just one thing after another. This man has a heart of gold. But more importantly, he's a dad. He has four children. And he's looking at his life going, my tennis career may be done. I'm saying goodbye to it, but I'm saying yes to my family. And I can only imagine how his parents feel looking on and seeing their son, who, by the way, is 6'10". Yes, he's a giant in himself. I mean, he's huge. He's like forever. Yeah, anyway, we won't even go there. I'm short, so everything's taller than me. But he's like, you know, it feels like 2 feet taller than me. He is huge. And he plays tennis, of all things. And he's good at it. Now, you may have never heard his name. But let me tell you, anybody who graces his presence knows him. He's kind. Genuine, authentic. He cares about the person who is standing in front of him. And most importantly now, he's done with his tennis career to focus now on other things, specifically his growing family. They have four beautiful children. Now, as his parents look on, right, and say, oh my gosh, look what we did. I mean, can you imagine? Did they really think that, oh, my son's going to grow up and, you know, be in the U.S. Open and play for 17 years? They probably had no idea. Now, they knew, obviously, as he got older that he was interested in tennis and all of this, and they took him to tennis, you know, lessons and practice and all of that jazz, right? They were right there. But who would have thought, honestly, that that would have instigated the whole thing of him having a total tennis career? What's your child's career going to be like? if your child doesn't have a solid mindset, let me tell you, they're going to have a tough time living out their dreams. And playing for 17 years, it's not going to happen. Now, this is not to be a downer or anything. This is being realistic, and I think that's what we need more of. Because we look at our reels, and everything looks like picture perfect. Hence why I'm not on there. I have some things on there. If you go to my Instagram or if you go to my Facebook. But I don't go every day there. You know why? Because I come here every day. Because what matters? Your mind. What you hear every day. And that matters to your kiddos too. So I really want to challenge you to raise your children higher. And how do you do that? In a world that's just kind of like full of technology and distractions and honestly some bad stuff out there. To a degree, we've got to shelter our kids, but I don't believe that's the answer either. So I want to challenge you with this. Number one, teach with current examples. In order to cultivate a growth mindset and expand what they don't see, you want to encourage your child to view challenges as opportunities for growth. So emphasize the importance of effort, resilience, and learning from mistakes. Intertwine current events, what they can understand and associate with, so they can see how personal growth happens for everyone. Go back to John Isner. I mean, I'm sure there were times that his mom was like, oh no. And he probably got in trouble and he was probably grounded and couldn't do some things or whatever it was. He's a Georgia Bulldog. Go Bulldogs. Maybe that's you. You cheer on that team. But when you think about how you teach your child, you've got to use current examples, right? It's got to be relevant. Because if not, honestly, they're just going to tune you out. And let me tell you, they have the quickest mute button for you than anything in the world. Seriously, and they know how to do it, and they do it well. And if they're wearing anything in their ears, I guarantee you, they just have to turn up the volume. And then you're drowned out, nothing matters. You really want to allow them to understand from a current event perspective. It's got to be relative to them. They have to understand like, oh, wow, I can relate. Right? So maybe you need to be on TikTok, not so you can do something on TikTok, so you can find something if they're on TikTok. And let me just say, if they're on TikTok, we need that for another episode too. And if they are on social media, I pray that you have access to their accounts. Obviously, if they're an adult and they're grown, well, okay, good luck with that. But if they're young, I hope you're watching them. I hope you have their passcodes, because you should. Now, that doesn't mean you have to go and snoop on them every day. But by golly, if something comes up, yes, you need to, because you are their only protection. No one else is going to fight for your child as you know your child, because you know your child best. So teach with current examples. Share personal stories. Now, don't make it all about you, because honestly, as they get older, they're going to be like, Mom, I don't want to hear this again. Okay? So come up with something fresh. If they're into football, for example, then if you live maybe near a big university and you like that university, then get to know a player or two, not literally, but get to know them as to who they are and what they stand for, so you can use them as examples and say, well, what do you think if you're watching a game? Well, what do you think he did? He decided to make that play. Why did he do that? It allows their minds to be opened up further. And remind them that with determination and faith, they can overcome any obstacle. Remember, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Nothing is impossible for our kiddos. But we have to help them understand so they expand their mind, right? So they can dream even bigger, but then they have the skills and the faculties to move forward. And a lot of times, I'm telling you right now, it's not being taught in the schools. And remember, I'm the homeschool mom, the traditional school mom, and the private school mom. I've been down all those roads. I'm a teacher too, not just from homeschool. I taught in the school system. So it's one of those things. And my mom, yeah, I grew up with education in my family too. So it's like a double whammy for me. Teach with compassion and empathy. That's number two. Open their hearts to understand more than what they can see or feel. Help them express themselves in a way that brings comfort to their growing selves, who they're becoming. And then being able to understand someone else's position without dragging them through the mud. We've got to be able to have conversations without getting all riled up. Now, that doesn't mean you can't kind of like become a little bit more passionate and your voice volume, you know, increases. That's going to happen. But you can still do it in a manner that's not degrading. You can do it in a manner that is respectful. But we're not teaching that. It's, oh, I'm right. And I can do this because, well, you know, I can do this. Just because you can breathe doesn't mean you should do it. And are we teaching that to our kids? I know this is a lot, but like I said, it's confessions. I'm just letting it all hang out. Number three, teach critical thinking. Who thinks for themselves today? Not very many. All the more reason why you need to teach your children the skill. Your children need to have the competency and the confidence to ask questions to learn more, to facilitate further discussion, and to grow in knowing what they don't know. And that's a hard thing. Because everybody now, right, with social media, oh, I know this. YouTube, you go on there, how to. Just type in how to and anything after. There's about 2,000 videos minimum on anything you could think of. And when I think about that, it's kind of scary. I'm thinking, I don't want to write down everything. No, not me. Don't you want your children to learn how to think and not rely totally on technology? I'm all for technology. I get it. It's wonderful. I don't have to go look up an encyclopedia, which, you know, I did when I was growing up. But it's good to understand the process. It's good to understand, wait, I can go look online, but what does that mean? What does research really mean? Asking more questions. Looking at different points of view. Digging deeper. A lot of people nowadays are just sitting there going, well, I was told this, so that's it. That's the truth. And we see tons of it on social media. And this is not a social media bash day, by the way. There's a place and a time for social media. But mom, there's a time and place for you, always. Dad, you too. Dad, you got to be involved. Don't put all the pressure on moms. I'm serious. Our kids need their father figures. And if for some reason you're a single parent, whether male or female, get some support, some other people that can fill the need there that is missing. So if you're a single mom, then make sure your children have a strong influence. Maybe it's their grandpa. Maybe it's someone at church, a good close friend of yours. We need to have those relationships. We need to encourage our kids to think for themselves, to not just assume that, oh, what I hear is truth. That's not right. And you wonder why we're in the situations that we're in sometimes. Remember, it is important to be sensitive also to the age and maturity level of your child. So as you're having these conversations, just don't assume that, oh, they can handle this. They may not understand it. So simplify it. And if you're not sure if they're getting it, have them repeat what they heard you say. Say, well, tell me what you thought mom was talking about. But let me also tell you this. Don't be preachy. Don't take 20 years, 3 days to, you know, explain something. You got to be quick on your feet. And it takes practice. And yeah, you're going to get some things wrong, but that's okay, right? It's better to try than not do anything. They're going to know you're showing up, even though you may not have all the answers. But be there. Remember, these are little gifts, and their minds are so fragile. And we've got to care for them. So adapt your approach accordingly to ensure that your kid is grasping the message and they're not going to feel overwhelmed. And that's hard to do. But you know your child, so have confidence in that. And then let them ask questions. Be quiet. Just let them ask questions. Of course, you can answer them. Because mom, dad, you only get these opportunities once in a blue moon. Go in peace. Be present. Be incredible. Be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Hey, have a beautiful Labor Day weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.